Hi, very good morning. I'm so privileged and honored to be sharing this morning with incredibly amazing women who have been with us today. Endometriosis. Let me show you a picture of female reproductive system. This is female reproductive system. This is the uterus, fallopian tubes, and ovaries. Endomene inside. Endometrium is inner layer of the uterus. So endometriosis is present of an endometrial glands and stroma outside of the uterus, where they normally found inside is present outside. The symptoms of endometriosis is quite variable. They can range severe pain to no symptom at all. The most common symptom is pain with periods, pain outside of periods, pain with ovulation, pain with urination, and pain with bowel movements. And very often we find endometriosis incidentally during evaluation of other gynecological problems such as infertility. Other symptoms are changes in menstrual cycle. Women may notice that their periods get heavier, make more clotting, and irregular. Other symptoms are bloating, tiredness, anxiety, depression, and they feel that they are not functioning well. Actually, nobody is listening to them. Endometriosis can only be diagnosed definitely by surgery and biopsy. But we can't take everybody to the operating room just to make that diagnosis. As an Ayurvedic doctor, we can see ultrasounds, blood test, and all. Is period pain normal? No. If the period pains impact your quality of the life, then that is not normal. Unfortunately, among both health professionals and our general community thinks that period pain is normal. That is not so. We more often see endometriosis among infertility population. But endometriosis does not equal infertility. We can't fully understand which endometriosis is impact to the ability of become pregnant. Yes, endometriosis often recurs. We know looking at some studies, sometimes endometriosis be stable and sometimes it may be progress. If a woman suspects that she may have endometriosis, first step will be going to a doctor and discuss her symptoms. Additional testing and exams will be done. In advanced stage of this disease, treatments are quite complex. Endometriosis can be laid over the bowel, over the bladder, over the uterus, and over the ovaries. Rarely, it can be laid over the lungs too. Actually, you know, nobody come directly to the Ayurvedic treatment. But as an Ayurvedic doctor, I can say we have very good treatments and we have very good Ayurvedic preparations as there are various herbs in nature. Let me show you some reports. Here, the patient before the treatment, right ovary volume is 31. There is a cyst 3.3, 2.4 by 2.7. And left ovary is 36 milliliters and several cysts are there, 2.6, 2.2 is the largest one. During the treatment, right ovary is normal, it is 3.2 milliliters and only one cyst in left ovary, 3.6 and 5.8. Then after the treatment, uterus appear normal, no masses or cyst, no sonographic evidence of gynecological pathology. I'll show you another report. Here, this patient before the treatment, 4.8 cyst is there. This is after the treatment ultrasound scan report, no cyst at all. Another report. Here, these patients suggest to do TAH. TAH mean total hysterectomy. That mean remove the uterus. She has adenomyosis and endometriosis both. Adenomyosis mean enlarged uterus, endometrial patches in uterus. During the treatment report, ovaries, uterus is normal and one cyst 3.6 and 3. This is after the report, no pelvic pathology, normal report. As we have so many herbs in Ayurveda, they will balance all the three doshas of your body. And thank you very much for being with us today, and have a nice day. We will meet you soon.